Good morning, my dear students. See, in the earlier class, we have understood about the calculation of total product when the unit of labor used is given, isn't it? And we have calculated the marginal product value, that is MP, then average product value, isn't it? The total product value can be determined by using the formula like sum of MP. By adding the marginal product value, you can obtain the total product value, isn't it? Then we can calculate the marginal product value by using the formula TPN minus of TPN minus 1. Okay, then we have calculated the value of average product by using the formula total product divided by L, where L is one of the input factor. Okay, then afterwards we have understood about very interesting topic, that is about the law of variable proportion, or also we can call it as law of diminishing marginal product. How do you state this law of diminishing marginal product, or law of variable proportion? See, it states that the marginal product of a factor input initially rises with its employment level, but after reaching certain level of employment, it starts falling. That is known as what? Law of diminishing marginal product, isn't it? The sentence itself is telling us that as we go on increasing the number of units of labor use, what happens? To a certain extent, the marginal product value will be increasing. But after reaching a certain level of employment level, means after certain unit, in our example, if you observe there, after reaching a fourth unit of number of unit of labor use, what happened there? The marginal product value starts decreasing. It started decreasing, isn't it? That is a law of diminishing marginal product, isn't it? Then we have taken a example. We have drawn a table there. We have drawn a diagram. See, in that table, you have drawn four columns where it is representing number of units of labor, that is L, then total product, then marginal product, then after that average product. In that, what happened? You have taken the number of units of labor use ranging from 0 to 6, isn't it? So when you are employing first labor, the total product value was how much? It was 10. See, when you are using a number of units of labor use as 1, there the total product and even the marginal product and average product, it was of same value, that was equal to what? 10, number 10, isn't it? So as we went on increasing the number of units of labor use, the total product value is increasing, isn't it? It is increasing, that you can observe in the table. And what about this marginal product value? See, initially it is increasing, that is up to third unit of employment level it is increasing, but after reaching the fourth unit of labor use, what is happening there? There the marginal product value is decreasing, isn't it? So even the average product also, that's a case that is happening. Initially it was increasing, and after reaching fourth unit of labor, it also started decreasing. Okay, then to understand this still in a better way, we have drawn a diagram. That is, on x axis we are considering the number of units of labor used, and on y axis we are considering the output, isn't it? By using the values that what we have obtained in the table, we have plotted the values on the diagram so that you have obtained the curve. That is three types of curves. Which are those? Total product curve you have drawn, then marginal product curve, and the lastly the average product curve, isn't it? There also you can observe diagrammatically wherein the total product value is increasing as there is an increase in the number of units of labor used, and marginal product, what's happening to that? It's also increasing initially, but after employing the fourth unit of labor, the marginal product value is decreasing, isn't it? It is also in the same case in case of average product. Okay, so today we shall know about the shapes of this total product curve, how it will be, what will be the shapes of this total product and marginal product, along with that the average product. So what will be the shapes of this total product, average product and marginal product curves, that we will be discussing now. Okay, so before knowing this, tell me, what do you mean by total product? So now we will be discussing about shapes of total product marginal product and average product curves. Okay, this is important question for the exam. It might be asked for 6 marks in the exam. Okay, it's important topic. It might be asked for 6 marks in the exam. So listen carefully, understand this topic. Okay, it might be asked for 6 marks. It's a 6 marks question. See, to understand about this curves, shapes of this different types of product curves, we want an example. So let me write that table. Okay, before writing that, tell me, what do you mean by total product, what is meant by marginal product, then what is meant by average product? What do you mean by total product? Total product means the total volume of goods and services that is produced during a specified period of time, that is generally during a year, that is known as what? Total product. Then what do you mean by marginal product? See, marginal product is the ratio of change in output to the change in input, isn't it? Then what do you mean by average product? See, average product means it is the output per unit of variable input. It is the output per unit of variable input. And we can calculate the average product by using the formula TP divided by L, isn't it? So this is the meaning of these concepts. Then to understand this different types of product curves, we require a table so that we can understand very clearly. So let me write this table along with the values of total product, marginal product and average product. Okay, draw 4 columns. In the first column, consider one of the input factor of production, that is labor, L. Okay, then total product, TPL, marginal product, MPL, it can be abbreviated as MPL. Then we have our average product, that can be abbreviated as APL. Okay, so labor, number of units of labor use, consider it from 0 to 6, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so let me take the marginal product value initially. See, when the number of units of labor use is 0, I have said that there is no production process, then what will be the value of output? It will be 0. It might be total product or marginal product or average product. So take it as 0. Okay, means there is no production process, it is a meaning. Okay, so marginal products, take a values like 10, 14, 16, 10, 6, 1. See, the example, it's a value, numerical value, whatever you want you can take, but see that for the values whatever you take, the marginal product value should be increasing initially, but after reaching certain value of input, it should be decreasing. So such kind of values you can take. You can take any numerical example. Okay, other example tagobodu. Marginal product value enagtirbek namage initially number of units of labor use jaasti aadangela idu kuda jaasti aagbeku. But after reaching certain level enagta hogbeku andre marginal product value nantara kadme aagta varbeku. Okay, so when we know the values of marginal product, it's very easy for us to calculate the total product value because we know the formula, isn't it? So how do you calculate this total product? Total product can be determined by using this formula, that is sum of MP, isn't it? So 0 plus 0, 0 only. When the marginal product value is 0, obviously total product is also 0. So 0 plus 10, how much you'll get? 10. Okay, 10 plus 14, 24, 24 plus 16 is 40, 40 plus 10, 40 plus 10 is 50, 50 plus 6 is 56, 56 plus 1, 57. Okay, then when you are knowing the values of total product, easily you can determine the values of average product because we know the formula. Average product is equal to what? Total product divided by L. See here what happens. 10 divided by 1 is 10. 14 divided by, 10 divided by 1 is 10. 24 divided by 2 is how much? It is equal to 12. Okay. Then 40 divided by 3, you will get 13.33. Next, 50 divided by 4, you will get 12.5. Okay. Next, 56 divided by 5, you will get 11.2. Next, 57 divided by 6. We'll get 9.5. Okay, 9.5. So with the help of this table, I can explain about this TP, MP and AP curves along with the diagrams. Even I have to draw the diagrams which shows the shapes of this different types of curves. Okay. See here, what's happening is an increase in the input of one of the input by keeping one of the input constant and by changing another input, what's happening is there is a increase in the output. We can say that if you consider, in this case, if you consider two inputs, that is one is land and another one is labor, what is happening is you are keeping the one of the input factor, that is land, as a constant value. Alva land input na en martidira neevu aduna constant value anta tagotidira. Number of units of labor, this is another input, isn't it? So ee labor values na en martidivi, number of units of labor use change martta idivi. When you are doing this, what's happening is the output is increasing, that you can observe here. Okay, then in this table, you can very easily identify that as we are increasing the number of units of labor used, what's happening in the case of total product? It is increasing, isn't it? Zero earlier, it was zero, means when there was no labor was employed, means when the L value was zero, so the total product was also zero. And when you are employing only one labor in the workplace, what's happening is you have obtained 10 units of total product. Again, when you are increasing the number of labors used, that is it is 2, then even the total product has been increased, isn't it? So here you can see it is equal to how much? It is equal to 24, means it is increased by 14 units, isn't it? So we can say that when one of the input factor is kept constant and another input is changing, or when it is a variable factor, the output can be increased, or we can observe the increase in the output here. Okay, so then what will be the shape of the total product curve then? So first let me draw the shape of this total product curve. Okay, so to draw this, we have to consider labor and total product, that is labor on x axis, number of unit of labor on x axis, and the output on y axis. Okay, on horizontal axis, that is on x axis, this is a origin O and this is a y axis. So on horizontal axis you consider the number of unit of labor used. Okay, number of unit of labor used. And on y axis you consider output, output. Okay, so when you are using a L unit, suppose if you are using a L unit of labor and if you are producing Q quantity or Q1 quantity of output, then the shape of the total product curve will be in this manner. That's what I'm going to write it now. Okay, so this is a Q1 quantity of output that is produced by using L unit of labor. Okay, so then draw this. See, this is a total product curve, TP. Yeah, you can write. So on x axis I am taking number of unit of labor used, and on y axis I am considering the unit of output, what I can obtain. Okay, so in this case you can observe, you can use L units of labor to produce Q1 quantity of output. Then look at this total product curve. What is the shape of this total product curve? In this case the total product curve, it is having a positive shape. Okay, it is having a positively sloped curve. What is the shape of this? It's having a positively sloped curve. Okay, the shape is positively shaped curve, isn't it? The total product curve, you can observe here, it is having a positively shaped curve. What do you mean by this? It says that as we go on increasing the number of units of labor used, the total product value is increasing, isn't it? This you can observe here, and along with the example also you can observe in this table, isn't it? So as you are increasing the number of units of labor used, the total product value is also increasing. Okay, so what is the shape of this total product curve? The total product curve is having, the total product curve is positively shaped curve. Okay, remember this. Then we shall understand about the marginal product and average product curve. Okay, I think it's clear. Total product curve is having a positively shaped or positively sloped curve. Okay, it is having a positively sloped, don't want to write shaped, it is positively sloped curve, positively sloped curve. Okay, see, in the law of variable proportion or in the law of diminishing marginal product, you have understood that the marginal product value will be increasing at a certain level of input, but after reaching certain level of input the marginal product value will be decreasing. So in the statement you have come across that the marginal product of a factor input initially rises with its employment level, but after reaching a certain level of employment the marginal product value will be decreasing, or we can say that it starts falling. Okay, so here you can observe in this case, in the variable proportion, in the law of variable proportion, there you have taken the land as one of the input factor and it is remaining constant, isn't it? And another input factor what we have considered is labor. So here the number of units of labor use is increasing. Okay, then what is happening to this marginal product value then? See, when you are using a one unit of labor, the marginal product value is 10, isn't it? Then when you are using a two unit of labor, the marginal product value is 14. Okay, it means what? It is increasing as we are increasing the input factor, that is labor values. Again, in the third case, what's happening is when you are using the third unit of labor, the marginal product value is how much? It is 16. Then when you are using fourth unit of labor, the marginal product is decreasing. You can see here it is becoming